and start their own new family with its own history. With its own history, traditions, and bonds that make a family worthy. James Nelson Dawson, I understand that you're here today to enter into a Christ-centered marriage with Candace family. Go on. Do you promise to love her and cherish her, honor her, and be the faithful and be faithful to her as long as you love God? Candace family, go on. I understand that it is your intent today to enter into a Christ-centered marriage with James Nelson Dawson. Do you promise to love him and cherish him, to honor him, and to be faithful to him as long as you both shall be? And who wins this one? Who married this one?
My mother and I.
Celebration and a celebration. just making a public statement about the commitments that you all have made. That is, you want the world to know that you love each other well, that you want to spend the rest of your lives committed to each other. In some ways, it can be a period of for a person to form a public act to show his commitment to Christ. It's not the water that brings salvation. It's the belief in the commitment to Christ. So it's not a ceremony, it's a true lasting commitment to each other. Now, marriage brings with it some difficult and some wonderful concepts. When you retain your individual identities, you also form a new identity. Candace and Elsa and Candace. You're going to be the couple, the family from now on. In years to come, the memories that you have will start to blur and blend together into a common consciousness. The memories of this day will become part of your family history. Someday your children are going to look back on the photos that are being made today, and they're just going to go, I have a whole passion for God's because I'm sure you've done that with your parents' homes. And when they are old, they will cherish the photos. Tell them to their children, telling them this is how their grandparents lived a long time ago. Another mystery of marriage is how is that you are not just marrying each other, you're marrying into each other's family. While you're creating your own new family, you're also joining with the others in creating a new branch. Candace, you'll be the new daughter to Nelson's parents. And Nelson, you'll be the new son of Candace's parents. And there's no stronger or more important thing to know than Candace and Nelson, right now you're probably asking yourselves, what? I'm getting this. I know it's scary. It's a big step. It's one of the biggest decisions you've made in your life up to this point. So let me tell you what I think you may hear against it. I know that up to this point you both, we've talked about this, you've had a lot of adventures, you've traveled, you've been around the world, you've seen a lot, you've seen a lot of interesting things, and had a lot of awesome experiences. But today, you're leading into a lifelong adventure with your very best friend. And not only will you have someone to share all of your great joy with, you'll have someone to help you and encourage you through times of disappointment. You will have someone beside you face the world in this little process. Nelson, this will be the mother of your children, and this will be the father of your children. You're getting them the best thing that can ever happen. Now let me give you a little bit of advice. We've already heard 1 Corinthians 13 read, but I'll go over a few of the verses one more time. In there, Paul talks about love, and he talks to you, what he does is the best definition of love that you can find. And he says in there, love is patient and love is kind. What he's telling us is you need to be patient and kind with each other. Remember, you're in a partnership, and it's the best thing you've got going on each other. It does not envy, it does not boast, it does not doubt, it does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking. So always cheer each other on. Want the best for each other, and always be willing to say, I'm sorry. He goes on to say that love is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. So be willing to forgive and forget. Love always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. There's always that sentence right there. That means that your love is eternal. It will always do these things. It should never, ever go away. So with all that said, Candace, Nelson, you would say Candace about the hand who's wearing it and look into her eyes and we're looking at her. Today I declare that I want to be your partner from you. You are my best friend and accomplice. I promise to live with you in truth. I will respect you, encourage you, and cherish you. And help and sickness through sorrow and success for all days of life. Today I declare that I want to be your partner. You are the best friend, you are my best friend in office. I promise to live with you truly. I will respect you. Encourage you and cherish you in health and sickness, through sorrow and success, for all days of your life. understand that you have brought today some tokens to exchange as lasting memories and symbols of the human that you're making. So could I have Candace? Our custom of giving rings at weddings goes back over 1,000 years, and it holds a lot of symbols. First, the rings themselves are naturally in the form of a circle, and in every culture of the world, the circle represents things eternal. When you wear these rings, you are reminding yourself and making a public statement that you are eternally committed to the universe. Daily, as you look down on your ring, it should remind you of this love and that you are never alone. It will also prepare the world to your life partners when you are redeemed. The pure goal of the rings. Wow, that's even better. Nevertheless, they're always of a very precious metal, and that symbolizes the preciousness of the bond and the love that you have. So would you take this one and place it up against your finger? And we be I, James Nelson, Christ Mellis, take you, Candace Finley, to be my wife. With this ring as my promise. That from this day forward, you shall not walk alone. I have no greater gift for you. And may you walk together through all things. May you feel deeply loved for who you are. Each family has its traditions. Candace and Nelson are just beginning their journey, and they will keep some of the family traditions that they bring with them. But I'm sure that they're going to create some new ones along the way, traditions that they'll hand down to their children. But as members of the family of God and the body of Christ, we have a very important tradition handed down to us by Jesus Christ himself. On the evening before Christ was crucified, he gathered together his closest friends and commemorated the Passover meal. Now, being Jewish, this was just a normal part of the tradition that we'd always grown up with and passed down since the days of Moses. But on that particular night, Jesus did something different. Knowing his faith, he wanted to ensure that each disciple understood that his presence was not fleeting, but that he was to remain with them always in their hearts and souls and minds, so that they would not forget the need of the Spirit. He asked them to take the bread and the cup. So Candace and Nelson, why do we want to begin their marriage by observing communion together? There's no better tradition to begin their family together. By making this their first step, they proclaim that they want to keep Christ at the center of their marriage. Heavenly Father, we trust the Spirit into your hands, and we pray your blessings will always rest upon this home. The joy, peace, and contentment would dwell with Candace and Nelson as they live together in unity, and that all who enter their home will experience the strength of their life. So by the power invested in me by God and the state of Alabama, I now proclaim to you and to all the world that you are husband and wife. What God has joined together, let no man separate. Let's face the congregation. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Alabama's most beautiful couple.
Steve said he'd keep driving the other way. He doesn't like that. He's really blessed. Yeah, that's what I like, just trying to figure that out as far as the music can come up. They don't have any self.